Dates and time can be used to filter the dashboard data. So over here I want to add a new filter, and I'm going to select the date field. And with dates, I have several options on how I want the dates to be filtered. The first is selecting a list based on the specific time period, so years, quarters, months, and so on. Let's say I want to choose quarters. I can then select one or more quarters I'm interested in reviewing, and I can do this by using a list or changing it to a radio button to choose a single quarter. So again, let's choose a time period. You can see that the selection I've made is showing in the bottom bar over here. I can also choose the time period using start and end dates. I can choose any particular month and year combination, and I can select a specific date or time period. And you can see the time period again reflected in the bottom bar. Another option is to choose a specific time period, so if I want to do a comparison, like year over year or quarter or month, I might choose a time frame. So over here I can simply select the time period that I'm interested in, this year or last year, a number of years together, and so on. I can also choose it for a different time period. So if I want to do quarters, again I can choose the last quarter, last two quarters. So these are quick to use time frames I can apply to the data set. The next option is ranking. So over here I can choose a top or bottom data point based on a criteria. So if I want to choose, let's say, top 2 months, and then over here I can choose a particular value to base it on. So let's say I want to choose the two most costly months. I might come over here and choose cost. Of course, I can use other metrics as well in the calculation, or I can use a formula that I've created. Over here, it's going to show me a preview of the results set based on that criteria. Once I've made the selection, I can simply click OK, and you'll see the dates have been filtered. And depending on the type of criteria, I might get additional items over here. So instead of seeing the top 2 months, I can easily see the top 3, and the data will be updated accordingly. So this is a very easy way to apply date and time filters and narrow down the data based on a particular period of time.